New clues into the mystery surrounding COVID-19 as doctors learn more about the long-term effects of the virus and the damage it can do to your heart and other organs. A D.C. man is among the thousands of people impacted. He spent more than a month in the hospital with COVID, but new problems cropped up long after he had been released, problems that landed him back in the hospital with a life-threatening heart condition.
Staffers at MedStar Washington Hospital Center lined the hallway to celebrate.
Thank you so much, guys. You guys are amazing. Thank you.
André Taylor was finally heading home. The D.C. restaurant manager spent 38 days in the hospital, most of it hooked up to a ventilator as he battled COVID-19. He says it started with a high fever and then went downhill fast.
It hit me like a ton of bricks. And when I went to hospital center, they took my vitals and said your heartbeat was going 160 beats a minute. We can't put you back out there. Immediately, they rushed me to the back, and 10 minutes later, I was in a coma. When I went into a coma, it was like the COVID death count in the U.S. was like 120 people. I woke up, it was 24,000. I asked the nurse, I was like, what happened? And then she told me the date, and I was like, it's April?
When André left the hospital, he thought the worst was over. But months after recovering from COVID, he started experiencing new symptoms.
I had developed this flutter in my heart, and that was keeping me from being active of any sort.
That flutter was atrial fibrillation, or AFib. He says it was exhausting and frightening.
One of the things that we're starting to observe in our patients is as a result of the coronavirus, they're having inflammation in their cardiac tissue inside of their hearts.
Dr. Cyrus Hadadi is a cardiac electrophysiologist at MedStar Washington Hospital Center. He says that inflammation can infiltrate the heart's electrical system, causing an abnormal heartbeat.
How does a respiratory virus have that kind of effect on your heart?
We think part of it is because the lungs are so close to the heart inside the chest that the disease in the lungs can directly spread into the sac surrounding the heart, the pericardium, and then from there into the heart tissue itself.
Because the coronavirus is so new, doctors are just beginning to learn about the long-term impact and the heart damage it can cause, even weeks or months after the infection clears. For André, the solution was surgery. In September, he had an ablation, a minimally invasive procedure that uses radio frequency energy, similar to microwave heat, to destroy the damaged heart tissue that's causing the problem. It worked.
And immediately when I walked home, I even felt better. Like I ran up the flight of steps. I'm like, wait a minute, I ain't been able to do that. I'm 51, but I've always felt like I was 25. But I came out that hospital feeling like I was 75. I had to learn how to walk again. So I will say since my surgery, I feel like I'm my age now. I'm getting back.
Happy to report that André Taylor is doing much better. Doctors believe a significant number of patients, though, will develop irregular heart rhythms after a bout with the coronavirus. And they can't explain why it happens to some people and not to others.